Greetings. Good day. Salutations. We are reading for the collective today. Tarot Tuesday. We do this once a week. Weekly readings for everybody, all 12 houses. Starting in Aries, making our way all the way to Pisces. If it's your first time here, greetings, salutations, welcome in. We are just getting started, just turning on, just tuning in. Can you hear me okay? Maybe if you hear me all right, drop that sunflower emoji. Let me know, it's all good. Music too loud? Where are you tuning in from? Hi, hi. Awesome, Sam. Thank you dearly. I appreciate your feedback. Greetings, Liz. Salutations, everybody. Welcome in. Welcome in. Welcome in, Philly. Welcome in from Austin. We're tuning in outside the Midwest today. Dropping in for the collective. We'll be reading all 12 houses, starting with Aries, making our way to Taurus, Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, Libra, Scorpio, Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces. Welcome in, welcome in. We are just now getting started. Welcome in from Cincy. Welcome in from Minnesota. Oh, I see you, I see you. Greetings, my dudes. So stoked to be here today. We'll be playing with the Hermetic Tarot, as well as the Goddess Power Oracle. Welcome in from Iowa. Salutations, it's good to see everybody. We are just getting started, like I said. Thank you for the rose, I appreciate this, Kayla. We are making our way today to our goal. You know me, I love to be showering flowers. Roses are always appreciated. If there's anything that's ever in resonance and you want to drop a flower, you're always welcome to do so. Though ultimately knowing that your presence is a gift, and I'm so grateful that you're sharing time and space with us here today. Divine Sparkle 1111, lovely username. Thank you for the gifts. I appreciate this. Yes, happy 2323. It's 523-23555 out here. More like 557, but you know, if we're gonna go small with it, we'll keep it at that. Greetings and greetings and welcomes in. We are just getting started. My name is Gavin Zen. It's good to see you. Kayla, thank you for the roses. I appreciate you, dude. Do I have any Aries in the house? We're just about to get started with Aries, house number one. House number one is the ruler of the identity, the eternal sense of self, ego, who you are throughout your lifetime. House number one is oftentimes associated with the ascendant. It's also an Aries, sun, moon, ascendant, wherever you have a Mars placement, the ruler of house number one. It is seven, not five. You're right, Divine Sparkle, but hey, we're all learning. Not all of us are as good at math as you. I'm being facetious. Stoked for the collective. Stoked for my Aries friends. So here for it. Doubly Aries. I see you, Ashley. Groovy, groovy. We're just about to get started. But before we begin, I want to say thank you. Thank you for being here today. Thank you to all of my guides, my guardians, my angels, my aliens, my ancestors watching over me, allowing me to tune in here, to show up as a cosmic conduit to allow these messages to move through the. May we speak with clarity, with ease, with effortless ability, clairvoyance, honesty, and humor, shall we say. What a gift it is to play with these cards, to show up in this time and space. Greetings, everybody. We are just about to get started. We are just about to get started. So stoked to be here. Let me drink some water. Hope you got some water, maybe some tea or some snacks. We'll be here for a little bit. Cheers to you. And for the collective, my dudes, Aries, house number one, the messages that wish to move through, sun, moon, ascendants, wherever you have a Mars placement, wherever you have a first house today, this is going to be for you. We're going to cut the deck, we're going to clear the energy, we will let it rest. Leah, thank you for the gifts, I appreciate this, so kind of you, yes, yes, yes. Rusty. Lucky. Just have to get some energy moving. Give these cards a shuffle for the collective. House number one for everybody here today. We're going to draw two cards off the top. We'll flip the deck upside down to show the root, to see where this message is stemming from, and we will invite in a goddess. Ah, yes. for house number one. All of the cards are here in reverse, giving the sense that this is right around the corner, or the energies that we are to focus on so we can begin this cycle of integration as we're just beginning Gemini season. We have here Yostre, the goddess of new beginnings. A great way to start the day, Yostre. New beginnings here. We have the star over here in the root. Reverse, the daughters of the firmament, the star here for the collective. We have the magician as well, the magus of power. We have the princess of wands here in reverse for the collective. Aries, sun, moon, ascendants, princess of wands here. See the Aries ram? Everything in sync. We are here ready to read. What a gift it is to share this message. Squad, we are stepping into our cosmic essence. We are learning how to see ourselves as stars, recognizing that we are all stars out here. We are all made of the same energy that all the stars up in the sky are made out of. The more we can see ourselves in our cosmic aspects, the more we can then ground into this magic. Learning how to wield this, learning how to step into this, learning how to embody our gifts. Right now, we're seeing a great shift, not only for the person, but also for the collective. We are seeing an amazing shift. This Gemini portal just opening, beginning, reminding us that we are nothing more than the spells that we speak. We're nothing more than the stories that we tell ourselves. The more we can continue to see ourselves as stars, the more we can continue to embody into this way of beingness. Good evening, Zen. Good evening, Paige. Salutations. Welcome in, welcome in. I'm going to ask that everybody is mindful of their comments. Right now, we're reading for the collective. We're not taking any personal questions. Later in the evening, we will be doing personal readings, but right now we are reading for everybody just now tuning in. Yes, indeed. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We are just getting started with house number one, a great place to begin. The star. A lot of shift happening. Claiming one's power, claiming one's cosmic essence, claiming one's astral aspects, and learning how to see yourself radiant. Allowing your light to exude through every pore of your person unconditionally, unapologetically, without shame, without guilt, without fear. Knowing you don't have to hold back, you can allow yourself to shine. The stars in the sky, they don't compare themselves to the next star, they are just doing their thing. They're not concerned about if they're shining too much, or if they're in the right place at the right time. No, they're just surrendering to gravity and they're just moving through this outer space organically, and we have this capacity to do the same. The more we can see ourselves as stars, we can harness this, the more we can ground into this way of being this. But when this is a new beginning, it's going to take a second. You might trip up a little bit. You might fumble your words. You might drop some things here and there along the way. So be easy on yourself, knowing that only the truth remains. Continue to ask yourself, what lights me up? What turns me on? What makes me excited to live my life? What gets me out of bed in the morning? These are the fires that will ignite within your heart, that spark that allows you to continue to find your cosmic essence, your personal gifts that allow you to ground into your divinity and show up as the creator of your reality. We got this, squad. This is what we're here for today. House number one, what a great place to begin to play. We're flowing forward for the collective. Taurus, my friends, you are up next. Any Taurus in the house? Sun, moon, ascendants, just wrapping up Taurus season. We also have Venus placements. House number two is values. What it is that you hold near and dear to your core. These are collective readings. Yes, yes, yes. And then later in the evening, we will have paid readings. So if you'd like to jump in later, you'll be more than welcome to. But right now, we are reading for house number two, Taurus. I also ask everybody to maybe hit the share down there. You don't have to send this to anybody, but if you hit the share down there, or if you click the screen, it keeps this fresh on the feed so that those who want to see this from the For You can jump in here. Taurus, house number two for you, my dudes. We cut the deck, we clear the energy, we let it rest. I love it. The real ones remain today, today. House number two, Taurus. What do we have to say? Got an extra card for you. Yes. Oh, all the cards in reverse again, except for Yostre jumping in once more. But this time she's right side up. Yostre. New beginnings. We're continuing that energy from house number one to house number two, stepping into Lord of Material Success here in reverse. Six of Pentacles. The Lovers here. Children of the Voices Divine. Seven of Cups here. In reverse. Lord of Illusory Success. And the Chariot here. In the Root. The Chariot for the Collective. The Lord of the Triumph of Light. Here. For everybody. House number two. We are on track and we are here to keep moving in this direction. Being mindful of illusion, false success, not to get caught up in the distractions, the distortions, the external presentations of love or success, but more so turning into that frequency within. What does it feel like within my body? This new beginning is developing a deeper understanding, knowing, and feeling of what success feels like in your body. Right now we are here to ground into this rhythm. We are here to move to the frequency of love within, so that we can continue to become the material success. We become this, we feel this within our body, not needing anything outside of ourselves, knowing that we have everything we need right here, especially as we continue to ground into our core values and embody them and then show up in this way. The illusory success will continue to present itself. We're being called to practice discernment, to not get lost in our flesh desires and our surface level wants and yearnings. It's of course you're allowed, and it's important to have desires and wants, but what the universe wants of us is always going to be so much more great than what it is that we want on a surface level, what it is that our ego desires. The more we can tap into this Chariot card, tap into the flow of our soul and show up in this rhythm, the more we can continue to claim the material success that is right for us, ready and available. Continue to find your way to your heart space, the core within and all around thee, so you continue to ground to the seat of the Lovers, making love to oneself internally and then allowing this to flow externally, bringing to union your masculine and your feminine, allowing yourself to tap into your creative essence. It ain't easy. This is for the real ones. Appreciate y'all being here today. Squad, we're moving forward. Yes, house number three, Gemini energy. Any Geminis in the house? Gemini energy. House number three is communication. Sun, Moon, Ascendance, Mercury, Placement, wherever you have Gemini in your chart. This is all about visualization. This is all about the metaphysical and mental capacity and what you're holding in your space and how you want to continue to see it play out for you today. Yes, house number three. We are ready to get grooving, flowing forward, stoked for this. Gemini energy, house number three. Actually, it looks like some misery is wanting some company. I don't loathe any signs, never ever. We love all the signs here. House number three for the collective. Let's get right to it. We don't do chart readings here, no, we play with the cards. Though, if you don't know your natal chart, I highly recommend you go look up your natal chart. Absolutely. House number three. Flowing alongside this new beginnings energy, we have the goddess Isis here. Rebirth in reverse for the collective. We have King of Wands here in the draw. Prince of the Chariots of Fire. We have the Hierophant here in reverse. Magus of the Eternal Gods. Three of Pentacles here in the Root. Lord of Material Work. We are just beginning. We are just recognizing how to implement our soul and our visions into our earthly reality. We are rebirthing the way that we see ourselves and the world around us, that we continue to apply our magic accordingly, step into our King of Wands energy, and then showing up with discipline, showing up with consistency, resilience, and persistence. The Hierophant is an individual who shows up consistently, persistently, doing the work that needs to be done in order to anchor their magic into this reality so that they can share replicable results, results that are capable of being done and done and time and time again. The Hierophant is an individual who has a structure of like A, B, C, D, this is what I need to do, this is the spell I need to speak in order to create this reality that I want to see. The Hierophant is an individual who knows themselves dearly and also knows the way in which they work, so they continue to apply themselves accordingly to do whatever it is they want to. Right now we are reclaiming our power, we're stepping into our gifts, we're rebirthing ourselves as God, Goddess, and learning how to see the divine within ourselves so we can step into this, embody this, and then learn how to share this, ultimately. Because why else would we be here if it wasn't to share? Absolutely. Groovy. I feel complete with this reading. Gemini, pretty straightforward. May you continue to speak the spells that it is that you wish to see into your space. May you be able to catch yourself before you speak in a way that is negative or not in harmony with where you are currently, and continue to challenge yourself to choose that silver lining, to choose that more positive aspect, to choose the power within you. Yes, rather than succumbing or externally placing your power or blame onto outside sources, and instead taking radical responsibility of how you show up in the world and how you have the power within you. Godspeed, Gemini, my friends. House number 3, what a beautiful read. We're going to flow forward to house number 4, Cancer energy. We currently have the moon in Cancer, sun, moon, ascendance, Cancer for you today. House number 4 is the home, the space within your emotions. It's the first sign of water and psychic abilities. These are your supernatural gifts that allow you to continue to express your radical essence. Let's flow forward to house number 4 to see what they have to say today. Greetings and welcome in. We are currently reading for the collective. The High Priestess jumps in while we're shuffling. She's going to stay. We're going to draw 2 more. We'll flip the deck upside down. Lots of cards in reverse tonight. Lots of messages, lots of energies to be integrated, to be focused on as we're flowing forward. Gemini season. It's a powerhouse of the season. Right now, the more we can stay grounded and focus on the work that we're here to do, so we can continue to maintain the momentum that we are cultivating. Yes, Bridget, the goddess of creation. Creative spark here. The High Priestess, as I mentioned, jumps in while we're shuffling. This is the collective, this is you, house number 4. We have the Queen of Pentacles here in reverse. Queen of the Thrones of Earth. The Universe. The Great Ones of Nighttime. And the Hangman here. The Hangman and the Root. Reminding us that perspective is everything. How are we focusing on our energies? And how can we continue to see ourselves as the High Priestess energy? How can we continue to see the universe within ourselves and within everything? Obviously, the universe is everything, but sometimes it's so easy to lose sight of the universe and the connectivity of this world in which we exist. How can we continue to see how the creation, creator, creativity, creative spark exists and permeates this entire existence by grounding into this space, by continuing this momentum which we've crafted for ourselves today? We are reclaiming our thrones. We are stepping into the Queen of Pentacles energy. House number 4, right now we're being reminded of our perspective and how where we're focusing our energy plays an impeccable role in how things continue to unfold. Yes. Where your attention goes, your energy flows. May you continue to place your attention, your focus, your awareness, your perception on that which continues to uplift you, encourage you, and remind you to find your way deeper into your center. Yes, jams indeed. Good to see you, Kari. Yes, what a great song. Shouts out Four Non Blondes. Such an impeccable song. Yes, and Sensei, a great show where I was reminded of this tune. Yes, we're wrapping up house number 4 today. Stoked to be here. We are playing house number 5, Leo energy. Flowing forward. Sun, moon, ascendance. House number 5 for the collective. Leo. House number 5 is identity. This is how you show up in the world. This is how your home, your ideas, your values, your individuality is expressed and brought to the stage that we call life. Yes. Any messages for house number 5? Let us read these cards. Have a safe day. Of healing for house number 5 today. Gula in reverse. We have 9 of cups here in the draw. Right now we're reading for the collective, moving through all 12 houses. Right now we have house number 5, sun, moon, ascendant, Leo, lord of material happiness, alongside the king of cups. The king of cups and the fool. The foolish man here in the root. House number 5, I'm getting this strong destiny energy. I'm being called to remind us of our importance, that our soul came here with a mission, with a purpose, something much deeper than what we've been projected upon by society. Society's like, oh yeah, you need to go to school and get a job and get a family and all that stuff. But is that what your soul wants at the end of the day? Are you moving from a space of because you've been told to, or are you moving from a space because this is what you desire within yourself? Learning how to listen to your intuition and learning how to navigate this reality from the essence of a fool, an individual who's always traveling, and an individual who's always ready for adventure. Right now we are healing money wounds, we're healing this scarcity mentality, this lord of material happiness card here in reverse, alongside Gula here in reverse, is reminding us that we have made it and we don't have to try so hard anymore. We don't have to strive. We can slow down and we can find ourselves into our throne of water. And we can continue to listen to our intuition, because our intuition is always going to guide us in the perfect place at the perfect time with the perfect people. And if we allow ourselves to step out of our own way like the fool, we can then embody this path. We can walk this way. That is destiny, what your soul came here to do today. It ain't easy, but ultimately we are all stars, and the Leo card, Leo energy, is reminding us that we are the center of our own reality. We are the stars within our life, and where we can step into this energy without trying to put anybody else down, but not compete with anybody. We're just here to shine. There's plenty of space to do so. There's so much room out here in the cosmos. Continue to allow yourself to just unfold organically, be inspired, be easy, be breezy, and enjoy yourself ultimately. Listen to your intuition and go out there and be like the fool, as if you can do no wrong and the universe is supporting you. Then you'll continue to surrender and open up to the great mystery, and my goodness, by golly, that which you will experience will be so much greater than what you could ever have imagined or attached onto. It takes courage and a little bit of delusion. A healthy amount. We're flowing forward. House number 6. Virgo, my friends. Sun, moon, ascendant, Mercury energy. Virgo is the house of work. What it is and how we're supposed to apply our uniquity, how it is we are supposed to apply our individuality, how it is we are meant to show up in the world today, what it is our soul is being called up. Yes. House number 6, Virgo, sun, moon, ascendant. Strong cards. Underneath the Gemini Sun, we have the Knight of Swords here. For you, Virgies, all my Virg bros, all my house number 6 today, we have the Lord of the Winds and the Breezes, Knight of Swords. Princess of Pentacles here, reverse for my Virgo friends. Princess of the Echoing Hills. The Wheel of Fortune here, also reverse. Shouts out, Virgos. Oh yeah. Lord of the Forces of Life, Princess of Pentacles, Wheel of Fortune, strong Virgo energy, and the goddess for you, Morgan. The Morgan, the goddess of death and magic. Right now, we are being reminded that real work is speaking and utilizing our spells to nurture the seeds which it is that we are planting, to recognize how our intention, the way in which we are communicating, the frequency we are carrying, ultimately affects the way our entire reality shifts. May we continue to attune to the frequency of fortune, knowing that the wheels are here in your favor and they are turning in your direction. Continue to keep up this work that you have in cultivating. This momentum is amazing. Do not concern yourself about putting things to end, I shall say. Yes. We're allowing transitions to unfold right now, organically, effortlessly, not looking back. Allowing ourselves to release any insecurities, any doubts, any worries, any fears, any projections of ways in which we are supposed to live, and more so tapping into our own personal essence and recognizing that we have everything that we need. You're a freaking legend, my dude. May you continue to tap into your roots. This is the work, uncovering your truth, who you are on eternal levels throughout lifetimes, and letting this shine through you. Of course, we are here to honor our own personal experience in this myth that we are currently living, though ultimately, the story continues to play out through lifetimes. The more we can tap into that eternal cord, that wheel of fortune, the more we can allow ourselves to get out of our own way and embody our gifts, and then claim this greatness. Yes, that swords energy reminding us to cut through all that nonsense and to stay focused on what it is that we wish, what it is the universe wishes for us as well. Yeah, that galactic pony, absolutely, on those wheels of fortune, in perfect harmony. Godspeed, my G's, my dudes, I see you. And we flow forward, solid read. Thank you, Virgo. House number 7, up next, we have Libra, Sun, Moon, Ascendance, wherever you may have a Venus placement, wherever your house number 7 is. House number 7 is connection. House number 7 is relationships, it's balance, it's bringing justice to one's expression and one's work, how we continue to work alongside each other to ultimately share this space and co-create this reality. Yes, house number 7, Libra placement. Thank you for showering me in flowers. Appreciate you, Rachel. We are making our way to that goal today. Jenny says, you're a Libra Sun. Perfect timing. For all my Libras in the house, Sun, Moon, Ascendance. Let's see what these cards have to say for you today. We're going to cut this deck. Clear it. I'm going to do that one more time. Cut the deck. Clear it. And draw two from the top. Yes. Lord of Material Gain here is the only card right side up for Libra. 9 of Pentacles. Lord of Material Gain. Queen of Pentacles here. Queen of the Thrones of Earth in reverse in the draw. 5 of Cups in the root in reverse. Lord of Loss and Pleasure. And Metis, the goddess of wisdom, alongside this message, reminding us to practice discernment, to practice wisdom as we're navigating through our reality. When we're on one, it can be really easy to get ahead of ourselves. It can be really easy to get into our mind and be like, oh yeah, I'm doing so good, and get tied into that egoic way of being, but that's not what we're here to do. The Queen of Pentacles reminds us that we can't get lost in the ego, we can't get lost in the sauce, even the joy of it, because ultimately if we do so, then it's going to be really easy for someone to snag that throne right from underneath our seat. We're not here to get lost in the pleasure, but we are here to receive that material gain. The more we can move forward with a sense of gentility, I don't want to say being too humble, but you don't need to impress anybody, you don't need validation externally. It is important to move forward with a sense of humbleness, but you don't have to play it too cool either, to where you're not honoring or owning yourself either. It's all about that balance, and that's where this wisdom comes into play. You don't need to show off to anybody. You don't need to think that even you're the one who's doing it, because you wouldn't be doing it if the universe wasn't allowing you to do so in the first place. So the more that we continue to feel full within ourselves, feel whole, complete, not needing anything outside of ourselves, and grounding into this energy, this is the foundation, the frequency which we are then calling into our space, that will continue to encourage this material gain. So if it is ways in which you'd like to grow and evolve in a material fashion, first it begins up here, allowing yourself to place yourself into this space metaphysically, but recognize you're not doing it for the fruits of the labor. Shouts out to the Bhagavad Gita, reminding us the sattvic way is to do it because it's the right thing to do, not because we have something to gain. We're doing it because it's the right thing to do, not because we have something to gain. The material gain occurs naturally when we stay in rhythm with our path, with our passion, and we claim our power, but we're not here to get lost in the sauce of it. Be balanced, be grounded, don't overdo it. Find your edge and ride that edge. Godspeed to you, Libra House number 7. We flow forward to number 8. Scorpio energy. Scorpio energy, house number 8. This is the goddess of transformation, death, marriage. Scorpio is the depths, the darkness, the shadow aspects. Let's flow forward to house number 8 today. We're in the flow, stoked, ready to see what these cards have to say. Indeed, 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 shall we say. Number 8 for you today. Powerful cards. Knight of Swords here. Knight of Swords here. The Lord of the Winds and the Breezes in the Root. Alongside the High Priestess here. Reverse for Scorpio. The Priestess of the Silver Star. The Emperor, the Son of the Morning here. High Priestess, Emperor, Knight of Swords, and the Goddess, Uzume, here for the collective. Humor. Scorpio, we're being reminded to speak spells into the space that invite humor into our reality without the expense of anybody else. We are up-leveling our sense of humor, releasing patterns of sarcasm, we're releasing patterns of superficial laughter, and we're learning that the real laughter, the real joy, is that cosmic hum of the universe, that chuckle along. How can we continue to envision ourselves, hold ourselves in our mind and mentality? That balance of High Priestess and Emperor energy. This is strong Scorpio cards. High Priestess and Emperor here. Tapping into one's magic while also maintaining one's boundaries. Maintaining one's empire within and all around thee. It's a consistent practice. It's almost silly how easy it is and how essential it is. How easy it is to get lost of this and to get caught up in this external reality. But ultimately, the reality begins within. The more we can return to our own personal center, the more we can return to our own personal energy, your unique frequency, that which makes you you. This is how you will continue to exude, embody, and stand in your truth as the High Priestess, as the Emperor. The Knight of Swords reminding us how important it is to utilize our words and our thoughts to cultivate this higher sense of energy, High Priestess, Emperor energy. What thoughts are you allowing in your space? What thoughts are you entertaining on a daily basis? What spells are you speaking into your space consistently? Do you listen to yourself when you speak, or are you just speaking from a subconscious, unconscious space? This will play an immense effect into how your reality shifts Yes, nothing changes until our energy does. So the more that we can continue to stay fresh in the way that we navigate this reality, stay clear in our mentality, this is where some of the greatest work and level ups will occur. Yes, you are the Emperor and the High Priestess. May you continue to find the balance within this aspect of the experience, ground this, and grow from these depths. You got it. House number 8. Appreciate this. Solid message. We're flowing forward. House number 9. Sagittarius. Sagittarius. Higher thought, higher wisdom, greater guidance, universal law and truth. Shuffling. This is not going to be the card for you, but if anyone needs to see the home card right now, this is the higher wisdom. We are building home within and all around thee. Yes, Sagittarius, sun, moon, ascendants, wherever you have Jupiter placement, this is for you. Sagittarius. We have reverse in the root, the Lord of Fire and the World, the Sun card here. Sagittarius, represent. We have Lord of Pleasure here. Lord of Pleasure. Six of Cups. Queen of Pentacles here. Queen of Pentacles once again, this time right side up. Queen of the Thrones of Earth. And Artemis here. Reverse. Artemis, the goddess of focus for Sagittarius, reminding us the importance of our awareness and what it is that we are giving our focus to on a consistent basis. This will continue to play out into our pleasure or lack thereof. This will continue to allow us to tap into our power and ground into our roots as Queen of Pentacles, reclaiming our roles as kings and queens here of the earth. Us sovereign beings are here to reclaim our power and reign here unconditionally, unapologetically. The sun in the root, in reverse, reminding us to continue to focus our energies on seeing ourselves as a star, seeing ourselves in our cosmic essence, in our astrological aspects, and allowing them to unfold organically, effortlessly, in harmony and with clarity. Sagittarius, the message, the wisdom is to invite in pleasure, to prioritize this, because you're here to enjoy yourself and you're here to reclaim your power, and it's meant to feel like pleasure, though also keeping in mind that you're not here to get lost in the pleasure, you're not here to think that it's all about you either. Ultimately, we can choose to serve the self or serve the collective, and ultimately, when we serve the collective, we are also serving the self. How can we allow our pleasure to be in alignment with the pleasure of everybody? Absolutely. So that our pleasure is not at the expense of anybody. Yes. 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 May you continue to tap into this energy, to shine your light unapologetically, authentically, focusing your frequencies in harmony with the song of life. Yes. 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 Flowing forward today, Capricorn energy, house number 10. Paige, to answer your question, that was Hestia, the goddess of the home. Now we're flowing forward to house number 10, Capricorn energy. Sun, moon, ascendants, wherever you have Uranus, whatever you have Saturn placement. Saturn, house number 10 is foundation, this is legacy, this is reputation, this is also government energy. This is how our values continue to play out, how our work plays out on a collective level, and then makes ripples throughout entirety of reality. House number 10, Capricorn, for you today. Stop. two goddesses here. Capricorn, house number 10. We have the Five of Wands here in the root. The Lord of Strife. Five of Wands. We have the Devil here in the draw. Lord of Great. Lord of the Gates of Matter. And Temperance here. Daughters of the Reconcilers. We have Stillness, Yukiona, the goddess of stillness here. And also the goddess of forgiveness jumps in, Bronwyn. We're being reminded of the power of forgiveness, forgiving ourselves for when we've fed into the lower aspects of self, when we've chosen to cut corners and try to take the easy way out, trying to avoid the strife, trying to... Yeah, I want to say take the easy way out is the energy that's moving through. What we're being called right now to do is to prioritize stillness, to continue to practice temperance, to be able to recognize when the negative aspects of one's personal experience present themselves, instead choosing to navigate towards the higher polarity. Ultimately, we're not here to strive, we're not here to work too hard, we're not here to feed into temptation or to the demons or to the negative aspects of one's experience. We all have them. We're here to practice temperance, especially when we're being tested. And we're here to practice forgiveness for those who choose this energy. We're being called to slow down, to prioritize stillness, to practice grounding into one's presence, asking, who am I? Why am I here? And universe, what do you want of me rather than what I want on an egoic, subconscious, surface level desire? We are here to move and ascend and tap into greater desires that create the entire world, not just our own personal reality, but the reality that we are co-creating here together. Yes, indeed. We're not here to work so hard. We're here to work smarter, not harder. We're not here to feed into those devilish tendencies. We're here to be present, be focused, and to continue to move forward. And the key to that is forgiveness. It ain't easy. It ain't easy. It's a daily practice. The more you do it, the better you get, the stronger you become. May you continue to move forward with focus, with clarity, with persistence and resilience and determination. And we're flowing forward. House number 11, Aquarius. Sun, Moon, Ascendance, Aquarius. Wherever you may have Uranus placement, Aquarius is the collective itself. This is how we show up and connect and socialize. Aquarius. Yes. We cut the deck. We clear it. We let it rest. Bridget, making another appearance, the goddess of the creative spark here for Aquarius. The spark of the Aquarian age, shall we say? All these cards in the draw, we have Four of Wands, reverse. Lord of Perfected Work. We also have the Ten of Pentacles here. Ten of Pentacles, the Lord of Wealth, Lord of Perfected Work. And the Star here. Also reverse, the daughters of the firmament, the star, Aquarius. We're being called to tap into our cosmic essence. Once again, reminded that this is where our creation originates. The more we can see ourselves on this level, ascending or stepping out of our heavy attachment with this material reality, the more so tapping into our eternal aspects, our soul consciousness. This is how we can then embody our star qualities and then really begin to reign the wealth, reminding ourselves that health is the real wealth. The more that you can care for your body and its well-being, the more you can tap into your astrological aspects and embody them, perfecting this work, your health is going to shine amazingly, but also all of the opportunities, all of the resources that you could ever need, any desire and dream that you can think of can come to fruition if you allow yourself to place it out there and then get out of your own way, learning how to plant the seeds and learning how to nurture them properly. This is the path, perfecting this work of seeing yourself as the star, and in doing so, you will become the Lord of Wealth, however that is defined to you. It all begins within your creative essence, and knowing that this is your birthright, ultimately, as a being of God, as a child of the divine, of the universe, of nature, of spirit, you are here to continue to anchor into these aspects and share these gifts. Yes, this is where the real wealth arises. Yes, right now we're being called to continue to tap into these aspects, to ground into what it means for you to be a star, because we all are stars underneath that one big star above us. These bodies being made of the same energy, the more we can see ourselves as stars, the more we can anchor into this reality, uplift each other, amplify each other, complement, magnify each other on this wavelength. Yes, it's good to see you today. Thank you, Aquarius, for this reading. We are flowing forward for the collective to house number 12, Pisces energy. House number 12, Sun, Moon, Ascendance. Yes, yes, yes. Welcome in. It's good to see you. We are currently reading for the collective, reading through all 12 houses. We are on house number 12, Pisces, the last this evening. Pisces, Sun, Moon, Ascendance, ruling planet is Neptune. Pisces is the house of spirit, soul, beyond space, time, and definition, the last of the zodiac, bringing in the messages. What do we have for the collective today? Ooh, these cards jumping out of my hands, ready to play. I'll shuffle these one more time. Hello, fish. We got your card. That's how you know we are in sync. We have the moon card here. Mama Zuma, welcome in. Salutations. Good to see you here. Absolutely. Yes, we are reading Tarot Tuesday for the collective. Made it the best for last. Pisces, indeed. And your card, the moon. Ruler of the flux and the reflux. Solid synchronicity. We have the King of Wands here in reverse. King of the Chariots of the Fire. And the Lord of Oppression here. Ten of Wands in the root reverse. We also have the goddess Green Tara here for you. Salvation. I hear God's will. Spur. Such a solid synchronicity. That's how you know we're doing something good here this evening. Yes, stoked for it. Pisces, the moon is reminding us to continue to dive inward. The only card that is right side up, the moon, is our reflection of the stars, how we continue to tap into our soul. The moon is the ruling planet of the soul. Yes, may we continue to figure out what it is that lights our soul up within. The King of Wands here is the Lord of Flame and the Chariots of Fire, tapping into that which turns us on, that which reminds us why we are alive. This is where we can find our magic and our purpose. Learning how to tap into this and overcome the oppression of the society that is projected upon us. We're being reminded to tap into our soul aspects, to our gifts, and find salvation within. But also sometimes it's required of us to find salvation within external spaces that can take care of us, that we can seek refuge. This is that we feel safe to tap into our soul, to connect to our eternal aspects and our more internal senses of self. Because we live in a society and we live in a society that attempts to convince the individual that a soul doesn't even exist. You know, if you ask a scientist if souls are real, more often than not, they'll tell you no. I mean, things might be changing on a grand mainstream level, but more often than not, we're taught to think that These more subtle aspects of existence need proof or evidence in order for them to be real. So the more that you continue to tap into your intuition, you continue to attune to your moon, your connection with your soul within you and all around you, you're being rebellious. You're dissolving these projections of oppression and you're reclaiming your power. You're stepping into your divinity. You're reclaiming your essence and aspects as the creator of your reality, and you're playing your role here in this lifetime. May you continue to remind yourself that there's no shame in seeking refuge. In fact, it's important for you to do so, to continue to return home, to return inward, to go to the spaces that welcome you. You don't need to put yourself in spaces where you don't feel welcome. You don't need to continue to succumb to these aspects of oppression. No, you're here to reclaim your divinity. You're here to reclaim your aspects and essence as creator, listening to your intuition, and maybe even developing a relationship with the moon. If you don't already have connection and practice your own personal rituals when the moon is moving, wherever it may be moving, this can really assist us. At least this is one of the first portals that I stepped into to assist me to tap greater into my magic, was doing new moon and full moon rituals and going to events where it was encouraged to practice with intention to plant the seeds and the harvest of our work, so that we continue to align our own personal clocks and rhythms with nature's, because ultimately the biological clock does not react or respond to society's clock unless we allow it to do so. But the moon up in the sky is one of the greatest indicators of the clock of nature and how we can continue to attune our own personal rhythms to that of the universe. Yes, stay grounded, stay persistent, do not give up, do not give in. Continue to seek salvation, continue to return, to remind yourself that it's so important to recharge. You don't have to practice compassion to the ability of setting yourself on fire in order to keep others warm. No, we're done with that. We are learning how to practice compassion for ourselves. We are learning how to maintain our ground and our boundaries. It is key. Thank you, Pisces. What an important reading. Solid energy. We're flowing forward. Solid indeed. That was it. All 12 houses. We went right through it today. So stoked for it. So stoked for it. We'll be jumping in a little bit. We'll be jumping in a little bit. I'll say 15 to 30 minutes. We'll be back on here for personal readings. We'll be back on here for personal readings to jump in for the queue. But right now we are wrapping up all 12 houses for the collective. If you would like to catch this recording, it'll be up on my YouTube tomorrow by the latest. You can find that in the links. The YouTube is Zen the Alchemist. Right now, we are flowing forward. I do have Val on the Cash App, so she'll be up today. I don't know if you're here in the chat right now, if you already left Val, but I got you on the Cash App, and you will be up first if you are in the next live stream. If anybody else wants to secure themselves a spot right away, you can do so. Otherwise, you can jump in a little bit later when we are doing those personal readings. Zen the Alchemist is the Cash App, the Venmo. PayPal's else in the bio. Readings tonight are going to be 22-22. Drag her in. Drag Orion. I see you. I see you. Thank you as well. Awesome. When I'm about to jump on the live stream, I will click the like on the Cash App that you sent me so that you know I'm about to go live. And that way you can jump back in here. Cool? Got it? Yeah, groovy. You'll be up first. Awesome. I'm going to go freshen myself up, close out this live stream so that we can have it proper to upload onto the YouTube, get the recording. Awesome. And if anybody wants to jump in later for those readings, you just simply want to vibe out with us, you're more than welcome to do so. We'll be glad to see you there. Fantastic. Y'all take care of yourself. Thank you for these awesome readings this evening. See you soon. Godspeed.